Well, very excited. We are joined by Jordan Luck, a true Kiwi music legend. In fact, I love catching up with Jordan. He's always so happy all the time. And his new Jordan Luck band released their debut album today. Perfect timing ahead of New Zealand Music Month. And we're delighted to have both Jordan and guitarist Joe Walsh in
the
studio.
Good morning.
Hi.
Hi, Mike. Hi, Mel.
Lovely to have
Hi,
you guys
viewers.
Here. Now you feel pressure to be absolutely super over the top happy, don't you? Because Mike said you're always happy.
Oh, he's always in a good mood.
Elated.
You are, actually. You are.
Continually.
Well, that's really pleasing. Very pleasing. So you'll hear your brand new album. Is out today, and it's called Not Only But Also.
Indeed.
And you guys did a Boaty McBoatface on it, didn't you? You got the public or Facebook people to vote on it.
We threw it to our audience, and a plethora of names came back in, and we sat down, five of us, chose a name each.
And none of them were the same?
Name. So we're down to three, and then down to two, and then finally the one.
We had to phone a friend, actually.
I can just imagine being a fly on the wall in that meeting with that going down. It would have been quite interesting. And the guy who chose it, Daz Whittington, have you met him yet?
No.
You going to meet him?
Is Arriwa?
I think he's in Arriwa, yes. Now, part of the prize was to get a whack of tickets for a show of his choice, so he's coming to one of the shows on the tour, so we'll hook up with him then, I guess.
Fabulous. And, of course, the pride of having his name on your album.
Yep, he'll be in there.
It's a plus.
And Joe, I wanted to know, because I know that Jordan has handpicked this band. How do you think the sound of this album has come? You know, how would you describe it? Because Jordan, obviously, in control of a lot of things, but you're the guitarist, so what do you think?
It's still very Jordan, you know, very Kiwiana. Lots of storytelling going on, but it's been quite a while since his last album, Exponents album, so... Yeah, I think we'll surprise a few people with this one.
It's
a little punky, a little spunky.
Nice.
It's good. It's very Jordan. Still very Jordan, you know.
But the guys are Echo Park, D4, Dead Flowers, and it's a collaborative effort of that, really. So, yeah, it's a New Zealand record.
And when you were handpicking these people, do you pick them on their music ability or whether
their ability to tour?
All
right.
So
weeks on end in a van and being and staying in. Squats of accommodation, no food, and their ability to handle that sort of pressure. So
have you done any of the touring yet, or it's all going to come, isn't it?
Oh, no, this band's together about 5 years.
Yeah, so you have toured a bit. Yeah. Who is the worst person to room in with then?
Oh, how cruel!
Oh, there we go. You've just been busted.
They're all pointing at you.
Who's the snorer? Is it Jordan?
No, it's bass player Rich Mixture. We actually bite the bullet and buy him his own room, no matter where we are.
Excellent.
And this is really exciting, Jordan, because you teamed up with Dick Frizzell to do the artwork, and he obviously a very talented New Zealander. But you know, when you read about you, you're a member of the New Zealand Order of Merit. You were the first person inducted into the Hall of Fame in New Zealand. When you were kicking around, I went and seen you at Lasers Coliseum in Invercargill, I think, years ago. And you were fairly young then, but did things end up where you thought they would be with all that list of accolades?
I'm still surprised about going to China recently. Yeah, things that you never dreamt. Modelling, that's been a weird one for me.
What have you been modelling?
Oh, you didn't see it then.
No, yeah. No.
I was replaced by a pig.
Okay.
But I'm really happy for the pig. Especially its owners, because I knew what the fee is. So
that pig's doing very well then.
Yeah, it's not going to end up as a little bit of bacon.
Be a very expensive bit of bacon.
But is this industry
that was
like
fan club.
Is it what you thought, you know, when you started off, where you are now? Is this what you thought it was going to be?
I'm just astonished, humbled, really. But the thing is that as time goes on, the songs keep lasting, and that always surprises me. But then they belong to New Zealand, and be it For Today or Slice of Heaven or Rolling Moon or any song, really, Poye, come that springs to mind, Can the Beat, Flip, they belong to people, and you're just sort of glad that you wrote them.
Because you were talking just before about saying, you know, this is a New Zealand album. Is there a distinctive sound to New Zealand music?
Oh, Flip, yeah.
What do we sound like? What would you say, Joe?
Yeah, it's an interesting
It's vernacular of the instruments that come across, and not just name-dropping place names into it. It's actually a soul, I believe.
There's a couple of songs on there that are just really the imagery of, you know, as I've been here just over 10 years now, and you get a real feel for New Zealand from a lot of the music, whether it's Fat Freddy's or other bands that you sort of fall in love with over here. You just feel like, all these
Petrifier.
Bands, they just have, they have New Zealand ingrained in them. I don't know how it is or why it is.
It's such a great sound,
isn't it? You find
that,
you know, Irish bands have that sort of thing as well, but there's something about New Zealand music that, even through different genres, you know, even I find the festivals here, you can have so many different genres of bands, but they all sound like New Zealand.
Yeah,
it's
they
incredible.
Do, don't they? And it's so great when you're travelling overseas and you come back to New Zealand and you have that sound. It's just like a real homecoming, isn't it?
Yeah,
well, it's
great.
Been an absolute pleasure having you guys in the studio.
Thank you.
And we're looking forward to the album and also the touring that you're going to be doing.
Yes, and everyone in the audience is going to get one of these posters. I mean, look at this. How cool is that? Dick Frizzell has done the artwork. These two boys have signed it. I'd frame this and keep it. It'll be worth a lot of money one day. So everyone in the audience, you are getting one of these.
Well done.
Go and see these boys on tour. Thank you so much.
Thank you, guys.
Not only, but also the Jordan Luck Band. The album is out today, so go and get it.